done fiddling with it. Can't take it anymore. It's a good idea, but I just can't quite pull it off because it's a much thinner antenna than the other one was. Which is fine. It's okay. The rig will run just fine without the fancy. Alright, so we got freedom of motion. We're gonna go underneath, I think. Come up. Here's a thing I'd like to do. Just a tiny little bit. Get that kind of freed up a little bit more so I could get to the power switch. It's kind of annoying right that way. So, plug back in. Let's turn you off again. There we go. How about putting a roof on? And how it drives with a new radio, I'm sure it's going to be just fine. Like, basically the exact same. But now I can run both of my best 24 scales off of the G5. So, that's kind of nice. And I have a G7P on the way for the Das Hex / Fury Tech because I'm about to switch that to dual ESCs and get mixing working properly for front and rear dig for that. I have waited long enough to finish that rig, and it is time now to just buckle down and get it done. So, stuff is on the way. This is such a tight squeeze. I always feel like I'm so close to those mods are complete. Let's just push everything out of the way. Turn the radio on. Turn the car on. All right, let's give that a try. Definitely a much faster, stronger servo. Okay. Thanks for watching, folks. Really appreciate you hanging around this long. If you did, I definitely wanted to time-lapse through a lot of that, so hopefully that spared you a lot of the pain of watching me swap out a servo and everything in here. I think it looks pretty good. The reason why I didn't move the shocks up to this upper row, which is something that I've definitely been considering doing, but I really like how soft the front end is, and I really like how this has got plenty of reach. And from my experience and what I've been running it so far, I really like it this way. You know, to each their own on how they want to set up their front ends and stuff like that. I'm sure people would probably have their things to say about, you know, having too much flex in a crawler, but I don't find myself in a situation where it gets bound up, at least yet. Maybe if I do, maybe I'll change my mind, but right now I'm pretty happy with how this thing is running. So even the rear end is, you know, it what appears to be pretty loose to probably everybody else. I think this is, honestly, it's got all kinds of range of motion and everything. Awesome side stability, everything. I'm probably going to narrow up the rear end a little bit. I kind of noticed that might do a little bit better for axle clearance. Not really just necessarily just the diff, but just the whole axle itself. But still nothing really to complain about much at all. I'm just super happy with this thing in general. I think it's awesome. So, again, thanks for watching, and I will see you on the video. Next one, I guess that's what I'm trying to say. See you on the next video. Take it easy out there, everybody. Peace.